Moderators were sometimes told to ignore disturbing content.
This one. When Dollar's first cross is a little Negro boy. And it's been around for quite a while. This is an ignore because it implies a lot, but to reach the actual violation, you have to jump through a lot of hoops to get there. There's no attack actually on the Negro boy, it implies, but my golden rule is like if you have to jump to too many hoops to actually get what you're trying to think the content says, you've probably gone too far. So for this one, you should ignore this. Is everyone okay with that?
Facebook told us the picture does in fact violate their hate speech rules, and they're reviewing what went wrong to prevent it happening again. But on Facebook, not everyone gets the same level of protection.
I kind of instinctively think that this is a delete.
Our reporter is moderating a comment that says, fuck off back to your own countries. It's been posted beneath a video with a caption referring to Muslim immigrants.
That ticket there, fuck off back to your own country, and it says Muslim. Oh, immigrants.
Muslim immigrants.
If it just said Muslims, then you'd take this action. But it doesn't, so it's actually an immigrant.
Facebook allows users to say more abusive things about Muslim immigrants than it does about Muslims.
They are still Muslim.
What
are you saying? I said, if it's Muslim immigrants, they're still Muslims.
They're still Muslims, yeah, but they're immigrants.
Yeah.
So that, yeah, exactly, like, that makes them less protected.
Right? Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah, because saying that they're thinking might be physical inferiority.
Okay.
If it said, like, Muslim immigrants come, for example, that would be a delete.
People are debating very sensitive issues on Facebook, including issues like immigration, very currently, and that political debate can be entirely legitimate.
That's why you allow people to say, Muslim immigrants, get out of Britain, but not Muslim, get out of Britain.
We're trying to distinguish there between hate speech, which is against a class of people.
Do you not think Muslim immigrant get out of Britain is hate speech?
Again, this is something that we've looked at in a lot of detail. It's very hard. This is right on that line.
Is it hate speech?
It's right on that line. We've not defined it as hate speech. If you are, again, expressing a view about the government's immigration policy.
We discovered that some far-right pages receive special protection on Facebook.
The very same filthy, disgusting Muslim bastards that have been raping British children.
The Britain First Facebook page had more than 2 million followers when it was deleted in March while we were filming, after its leaders were convicted of racially aggravated harassment.
They got taken down, so they're not a hate group or a hate org, but they're just not allowed on the platform anymore.
Look, we've been tracking that page since it had 300,000 followers. It ended up with up to 2 million followers at one point before that page was pulled. The question can be asked, why did it take so long?
I was chatting about the Britain First stuff.
Yeah. It was pretty much like, we'd marked the pages so much for content, like, so much. Like, they had like 8 or 9 violations when they only had 5. But obviously they have a lot of followers, so they're generating a lot of revenue for Facebook.
If a page has 5 pieces of content that violate Facebook's rules, our reporter is told it should be taken down. But Britain First was a highly popular Facebook page. These pages are shielded and can't be deleted by ordinary content moderators at CPL.
It would never met the threshold before it was taken down.
Oh, I think it did. But it was just had too many fans, so it was kind of shielded.
What does that actually mean? What does that actually mean?
Stays up.
But when you say like shielded, it goes
to like another queue for like the FTs and they make that call.
Okay.
Yeah.
When shielded pages have content that breaks the rules, they're put into the shielded review queue so they can be assessed by Facebook itself.
What does shielded review actually mean?
Generally,
what's the criteria?
Shielded, like you just need to be more careful. So if a page has a lot of followers, you don't want to willy-nilly just take it down. You want to be 100% sure that you're taking it down for the right reasons.
Sure.
Okay, there's 5 strikes here, but this has like 1 million followers and they don't feel comfortable just like taking it down.
Yeah.
Call me and we'll have a look.
Was that like the Britain First stuff?
Yeah, something like that.
if it is a large page,
yeah.
Do they get sort of special consideration or...?
We're just very careful.
Facebook's special consideration appears to also apply to far-right figurehead Tommy Robinson.
Our children are being killed. They're being killed. If they're not being raped and destroyed in Rochdale or Rotherham, they're being butchered and maimed in city centres, outside concert halls. That's the future for our generations.
In March this year, Robinson was permanently banned from Twitter, but his Facebook page is still active. This May, he was jailed for contempt of court following a Facebook Live video he posted outside a court in Leeds.
You know, if you see one of these pages comes up, Tommy Robinson ones,
yeah.
Is there any point in me looking through the content?
Yeah. Like, don't worry too much about deleting their stuff, because those pages are, like, shielded. So, like, if you delete a video or whatever, like, you haven't deleted Tommy Robinson's video, it just goes to, like, this shielded review queue. But I can't see anything there. I think it's all banned.
With 900,000 followers, Robinson's Facebook page is so popular, it's been given the same protected status as governments and news organizations.
When they say freedom of speech, what they're really saying is, we really want to permit people to do whatever they want on this platform, and we will do the bare minimum to make that socially acceptable. Their business model is really tied to being able to publish whatever they want. And it, once you understand that the nature of large internet networks is that the harshest, meanest voices are going to dominate, what you realize is that the more open you make the platform, inherently the more unpleasant, inappropriate, bad content you're going to get on it.